Hi beauties, it's Miss Unique Beauty in the building and I'm back with another video. If you guys are new to my channel, tap that subscribe button so that you won't miss out on any of my new uploads. And if you have already subscribed, what's good, what's poppin', welcome back to my channel. Also, don't forget to follow me on Instagram and TikTok at Miss Unique Beauty. The items that you'll need is some thread, of course. I have two different types. I got the Gutermann thread and I got the Coates & Clark thread. You will also need your bobbin, and I'm gonna show you guys how to thread your bobbin, and a permanent marker. I also have my wig bands and some regular needle and thread, and of course my mesh dome cap. I like to use the mesh dome caps because they are very breathable. And a pair of scissors. The first thing that I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys is how to thread your bobbin. So you wanna go ahead and add your thread to the spindle at the top. Then you wanna use that white piece to keep that thread from moving. Then you wanna go ahead and pass your thread through step one. And then you wanna go ahead and loop it around the silver spindle piece right there. And then you want to go ahead and thread the bobbin. Now you want to make sure that you're putting the thread through one of those tiny holes. And when you position your bobbin on the bobbin spindle, you want to make sure that hole is towards the top of the bobbin. Then you want to shift the bobbin spindle to the right. Now I'm gonna go ahead and put my foot on that pedal, which is gonna allow the thread to gather. Then once you get that thread on a little bit, then you wanna go ahead and stop, cut off that excess thread, and then you wanna continue until the bobbin stops spinning. Once that bobbin is full, you wanna go ahead and cut off that excess thread, and your bobbin is complete. Now I'm gonna go ahead and thread one of my regular C-curved sewing needles, and I'm just gonna thread that because today we are making a lace closure wig on the sewing machine. So once I got my needle thread, I am gonna tie off the end with a slip knot, and then we're gonna get into applying the lace closure to the wig. Now I am positioning the lace closure a little bit in front of the wig cap, maybe about a half an inch in front of the wig cap, and I'm making sure that I am positioning the closure into the center of the cap, and I'm using my T-pins to do so. Now I am also stretching that closure to its fullest capacity, not too much, but stretching it enough to where it's taut and it's laying nice and flat on that wig cap. Now the wig that I'm making today is a middle part wig, so I have my closure placed in the center of the wig cap. Now if you wanted to make a side part wig or a deep side part wig, you would just position the closure exactly where you want it to sit on the wig cap. Now I'm gonna go ahead and clip the hair away to make sure that there's no hair in the way while I am sewing this closure down onto the cap. Now I'm gonna go ahead and sew the lace closure down onto the cap one side at a time, just to make sure that the lace closure is being sewn evenly on both sides. Now I am not making my stitches too far apart from each other. They are fairly close to each other, but this won't matter because I do go ahead and reinforce the closure with my sewing machine at the end. Now I am constructing this wig for one of my customers, so I'm not going to be showing you guys how I lay and slay this wig on my head because it is for one of my customers. But I am going to go ahead and do a separate styling video and a separate packaging video so that you guys can see exactly how I package and style my wigs for when I am sending it out to my customers. I do have a huge wig sale going on right now. All the wigs on my website are wigs that were featured on my channel or wigs that are fully handmade by me. They will be already styled and ready to wear when you guys receive your wigs. Check out my website, MissUniqueBeauty.com, and use promo code 210 for 10% off of your purchase, and all wig purchases are free shipping. The next step that I'm going to show you guys is how to draw your guidelines for where you're going to be sewing your tracks with your sewing machine. Now, I am going to go ahead and do two finger widths apart in the back, and I am starting off by drawing my lines going down the center of the cap. And I'm going to go ahead and do two finger widths apart in the back, and as I work my way up the cap, I am going to go ahead and decrease it to about one finger width apart from each other. Then I'm going to go ahead and finish with connecting the lines on the sides, going all the way up towards the temple and towards the top section of the cap. Now, once I reach the very top of the cap, I am going to go ahead and make some horizontal lines going across the top of the cap to close up that area in the top. And you want to make sure that when you guys are drawing these lines, you are making sure that the lines are as even as you can possibly get them on both sides of the cap. So what you do on one side, you want to make sure that you're doing it on the other side of the cap as well. And as you guys can see, the top, I am making horizontal lines across the top of the wig. Now I'm going to go ahead and cut away the excess cap underneath the lace closure, and this will also help you to be able to have some more flexibility when sewing the tracks onto the sewing machine. The hair in today's video that I'll be using to construct this wig is my Brazilian deep wave hair from my affiliate website, MissUniqueBeauty.maven.com. If you guys do purchase hair from my website, I do earn a small commission, so go ahead and support your girl. I did go ahead and custom color this hair for my customer in this gorgeous ginger blonde color. The next thing that I am going to be doing is doubling my tracks on the sewing machine. I did show you guys a tutorial on how to do this in my previous sewing machine video, so I am going to go ahead and leave the link to that video in the cards up above and also in the description box down below so that you guys can go ahead and check it out. I also show you guys very detailedly how to thread this particular sewing machine, which is the Singer Heavy Duty 4423 sewing machine. So I am going to go ahead and leave those links down below. Now I'm going to begin sewing the tracks to my wig cap. So I'm going to place my wig cap and the track underneath my needle. Then I'm going to go ahead and drop that presser foot down to tightly secure those two together. Then I'm going to go ahead and begin with sewing the track to the wig cap. Now you want to make sure that you guys are doing a reverse stitch when you guys begin and end your rows, because that will tightly secure these tracks onto that wig cap. This is what that first track is looking like, nicely secured, and this is what the underside of the cap is looking like as well. Super duper secured, super duper neat, and this is what you guys want your wigs to look like, nice and neat once it's completely done. Now I'm going to go ahead and cut off any excess thread and begin to sew on the next track. Now for the next track is very simple and easy, just like the first track. I'm going to go ahead and place that cap and the track underneath my presser foot. I'm going to release the presser foot so that the presser foot is keeping the track and the cap together while sewing. Then I'm going to go ahead and begin to reverse stitch to secure that track onto the wig cap. Now in this video, which is going to be a little bit different from the headband wig, is you want to make sure that you guys are rotating your cap as you guys are sewing onto the wig cap. If you do not rotate your cap, then the cap is not going to be sitting right onto your head and the tracks is not going to be placed correctly onto the wig cap. be sure to follow your guidelines that you have drawn, and make sure you guys are rotating that cap underneath that needle. Also, a big important thing is when you guys are sewing your track to the cap, do not stretch your cap. Make sure that the cap is just nice and flat and smooth, but do not stretch your cap while you guys are sewing onto the wig cap. Now, for the purpose of the video, I do have my hair on the wig cap facing underneath the machine, just so that you guys can see how I am sewing the tracks onto the cap. But in reality, when you guys are sewing and making your wigs, you want to make sure that you flip the wig on the other side so that the closure is going through the machine and the hair is on the outside of the machine, so that none of that hair will be in the way. But I'm only positioning the wig this way because I want to make sure that you guys are seeing exactly how I'm sewing the tracks to the cap. Now, the middle of this cap is going to be the easiest to mess up because a lot of stuff can get in the way while you guys are trying to sew onto those guidelines. Just make sure that that wig is as flat as possible, and you want to make sure there's nothing underneath the cap as well, because you don't want to be sewing excess hair or excess cap together while you guys are making your wigs, because then you're going to have to cut those stitches out and start that track all over again, or whatever tracks that was messed up all over again. So you want to make sure that you guys are reverse stitching when you guys are beginning and ending a track, rotating your cap through that machine, and you want to make sure that you guys aren't stretching that cap too much. You just want to make sure the cap is flat enough to where the tracks are being sewn down correctly. This is what the wig is looking like so far. As you guys can see, those tracks are beautifully sewn onto the wig cap. And I am gonna go ahead and show you guys the underside of the cap as well. And do you guys see how neat that looks underneath that cap? This is what you want your wigs to look like. Now, sewing machine wigs are amazing because it provides longevity to the wigs, and it gives your customers the satisfaction to know that their wigs will last a long time, even through the wear and tear of their wigs over time. Now, the wig is pretty much complete, but I am on here to show you guys how I sew the last two tracks onto the top. So I am going ahead and sewing one track where the closure meets the wig cap, and I am beginning that row with a reverse stitch and making sure to rotate the wig underneath the needle to make sure that I am still staying in the curvature of the wig. Then I'm gonna go ahead and sew my last track right where the hair begins on that closure to make sure that there's no gap in the top section of the cap, and also to reinforce that closure onto the wig cap as well. This is what the completed top section of the wig is looking like after I went ahead and sewn all of the tracks to the wig. And as you guys can see, this wig looks super duper neat at the top, and everything just looks gorgeous and beautiful. I really love how this lace closure wig came out. This is what the underside of the wig is looking like, and as you guys can see, this wig came out absolutely flawless. If you guys are in the wig making business, I really hope that you guys enjoyed this video because I dropped some gems for you guys. Now, this is what the wig is looking like roughly, and like I said, I am going to show you guys how I style the wig and how I package it to ship out in a separate video. Now, let's get into my slow-mo. I really hope that you guys enjoyed this video. Comment down below any suggestions or questions that you guys may have. Smash that like button and don't forget to subscribe. Bye, my beauties!